Hey everybody, it's Epic Underworlds, and in today's video, I'm going to be doing another unboxing. This one is again from the Game Crafter. I ordered some stuff for my game and a few other games, so let's get right into the unpacking. A ruler actually makes a pretty decent opening device. But basically what I ordered was every card in Epic Underworlds 2.0, which is this card game right here. I've been working on it for quite a few years, well, not that many years, but it was my main card game before, of course, I moved on to making Perpetual Cosmos, which I have quite a few new cards to show you guys in future videos, but yeah, so sorry for so many unboxings recently, I've just been ordering a lot of TCGs, which is awesome. So this right here is the Kingdoms Collector's Supply Block box. This just comes with a bunch of really good stuff to play the game, and comes with some other cool cards. I'm really liking this kind of ancient packaging design. He's really been amping that up. Then we have Saga of the Dragon Slayer, aka the Taharos starter deck for Skyscape, the trading card game. This looks absolutely sick. And then, oh yeah, okay, so we have every card in Epic Underworlds 2.0. So I'll cut back once I sorted all these, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Alright guys, this video is going to be a little too long, so I think I'm just going to open the Kingdoms Supply Box, or maybe the Taharos starter deck in this video, and then I'll show you all the Epic Underworlds cards later. But I didn't just order Epic Underworlds, I also ordered Underworlds TCG and Underworlds 1.0, as well as all the EU cards. They all have the same back, because I couldn't really do that in the same order, or at least I did not know how to, but yeah. I'll get back to you guys in another video where I'll do a bunch of videos on all these Epic Underworlds cards, but for now, we're gonna be, well, not we, but I am going to be unboxing the Saga of the Dragon Slayer starter deck in this video. So, yeah, let's get right into it. Skyscape has been doing some really awesome work on his game. I mean, like, he's just been putting a lot of dedication into his game recently. And just for a long time. It's not just recently, he's been working on this for a very long time. And, yeah, so I got this deck. I also have a few of the other ones. I'm trying to collect the whole series. I think I'm missing one of them. But yeah, here are all the cards. I'll look at the packaging too, but there's basically some lore on the back, which I can never really read on camera, unless I, like, look off to the side. But if you want to read that, feel free to do so. I'm really liking this. It's like, you don't have to put any detail on this top part, but I just like how he just jam-packs it with all this art. That's awesome, because usually I don't really look at that part. This, oh, the art cards. Heck yeah. By the way, the Skyscape art cards are so sick that I framed them. I don't know if I'll do it with the Taharos one, because I'm run out of frames, but this is the custom rulebook for the Taharos. I keep calling it it's the Saga of the Dragon Slayer deck, but I like to call it the Taharos deck. So I'm going to sort these, I'll get right back to you. Alright, well, something I can tell right off the bat that's a little different. I don't know if this is just me, if I'm not realizing this, but is there a lot more lore than, like, usually on these cards? Because if so, that is epic, because I don't remember that there being this much lore. But anyways, let's look at the art cards. The best part of the deck, we got this cool dude. They're all Cyclopses, by the way. A bloody axe. This awesome shot of Taharos killing some dragons. He's crying. This might have been... Actually, no. His parents were killed when he was little, so I think that was probably in a different card. Don't know much about them. It looks like they're doing like a blood promise or something. This one's a playmat, I'm pretty sure. Some sort of dagger. Taharos leading a giant army. The best art card. I love that one. Skyscape actually did a meme, and you know how, like, Shankfish is, like, one of my most popular characters? He photoshopped in a Shankfish, so Taharos was holding a Shankfish. I thought that was hilarious. This art I don't think is done by Skyscape, but this is also an extremely good-looking one. That is just epic. Wait, is that guy also dead? That better not be Taharos, although it doesn't look like him. Got this, like, old Luke Skywalker looking Taharos dude, Cyclops. Okay, yeah, this is when Taharos is little. This is one of my favorites. I think that looks really sick. Sorry again for, I don't know, like, I feel like I'm going a little slower in this video than I usually do. I just got back from some stuff. But anyways, let's look at some of the cards here. Ooh, that is a cool looking, what's a Kopish? Well, now we know. We got Crush. That guy looks like Gollum. That, I like that art. Some nice Ta-Hirosian weapons. Rotclaw Cyclops. You get that card in every deck, I believe. Hermit of the Rot. That's sick. Black Locket. I also kind of like how it's kind of going off the border. I actually like that art. Student of the Dark Arts. Triumph. Oh, so that's what this card is. That's cool. If you control a Tauros, Dragon Slayer, Cyclops, erase some of that you control, gain Guardian and Decay. So that really just. Whoa! Okay. This is sick. Cursed Rune Shield. Whoa. Guys, look how sick that art is. Jeez. I'm gonna put that off to the side. That is so cool. Cyclopean Shield. Cyclopean Gauntlet. Cyclopean Warhammer. Whoa, okay. This deck definitely has the best art so far. Like, look at this. Assassin's Scythe. Dude, that skull has so much detail. That is crazy. Jared, if you're watching this. This starter deck is really like amped up all the quality. This is crazy. Tahiros Dragon Slayer. Like the quality was already top tier, guys. And but like dang. So we got a few duplicates to make the deck stronger. If I do play Skyscape again, I've already played it. I thought it was really fun. I'm definitely gonna have to use this deck. I think it's aggro, but I'm not too sure what the playstyle is. Wastelands of Mokgul. I hope I said that right. Okay, this is also really cool. Black Magic Barrier. This looks like some sort of fortress. Okay, so far these are my three favorite cards. Although, of course, the Tauros cards are always my favorite, but like non-Tauros themed cards. Cyclopean Warhammer, another one of those. Ooh, Assassinate. Sever target card. You know, it's kind of nice just to have simple cards like this, especially they're really vital to a starter deck. Trample, sever target shield. Also nice and simple. Void Blade, and also, guys. Each Void Blade is different for each starter deck. So it uses the same like basic art, but the backgrounds are all different, I believe, which is extremely cool. Okay, this one is so cool. Tauros Young Slayer. Heck yeah, guys. I kind of just want to put this in a sleeve just because it's so cool. The Three Dragons of Despair. Whoa. Dude, this is so cool. I don't even want to play with these cards. They're so beautiful. Then we have the Omni Gadget. Rotclaw Cyclops. Okay, more duplicates. More duplicates. Ooh. Sorcery of Decay. And then for the last unique card, we have the Necros. Wait, the Necroses Dragon? The Necroses Dragon? Either way, that is the. Okay, wait, so. Does it say the artist? Honestly, I don't know. It might not. I kind of thought. Wait. That one says Jared Emmons. This one says Blackened Chrono. Either way, Blackened Chrono, that's a really cool art. But yeah, guys, that was this unboxing. Thank you so much for watching. Go check out Skyscape and of course Kingdoms TCG, which I'll be showing in the future video. But that was this unboxing. See you guys in the next one.